Good morning, all of you. Today we are going to start, okay, that is new topic, okay, that is velocity at an instant. How can you calculate the velocity at an instant? Okay, suppose t at t equal to 0, velocity is given. At t equal to 0, velocity is given. Velocity, let's say that is u. This velocity is u at angle of theta. At time t, this is at t equal to 0. If you want to calculate the velocity at time t, velocity you know very well, this is the path followed by the particle. This is the path followed by the particle. So tangent road at any point on the path, that will give the direction of velocity. That will give the direction of velocity. Well, the velocity the direction, how can you get the direction of velocity? You can do the tangent. Tangent. Suppose at this point I do the tangent. Okay, so this is the velocity. At this instant, the velocity that would be in this direction. That is in this direction. So if you want to calculate velocity at instant, let's say that is v. Let's say velocity is v. Okay, or it makes angle alpha with the horizontal. It makes angle alpha with the horizontal. So how can we calculate the velocity? Firstly, same thing. In x direction, you will write the velocity, initial velocity, initial acceleration. In y direction, you will write initial velocity and acceleration. So here, I am going to write here in x direction. In x direction, as you know, initial, this is the component of u. This angle is theta. What is the component of u on along the horizontal direction, along the x-axis? I have taken, this is x-axis. Horizontal direction I have taken x-axis, and vertical direction I have taken y-axis. Here, so you know as this component, that is u cos theta, or vertical component, that is u sin theta. Here, along the x-axis, this is u cos theta, or y-axis, that is u sin theta. So initial velocity in x direction, that is u cos theta, or acceleration along the x direction, that is zero. You know why it is zero, because that is gravity is acting vertically downward. Gravity is acting vertically downward. This is g, that is acting vertically downward. There, so there is no component, okay, along this in horizontal direction. So ax is zero. Now in y direction. In y direction. What will you write the initial velocity in y direction? As you know, we have done in the previous two sessions, that is plus u sin theta, and acceleration is ay, that is minus g. Yeah. Now you want to calculate the velocity at an instant. So which formula will you apply? V equal to u plus at. Okay, that is, v is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity, a is the acceleration, and t is the time interval. Clear? So along the x-axis, along horizontal direction, you can say horizontal direction, you can write vx is equal to x plus ax into t. You apply this formula, vx. Vx is the final velocity along the x-axis. Ux is the initial velocity along the x-axis. And ax, x acceleration along the x direction, that is zero, that is given, or t is time, at time t. Because you have taken t is zero. So now you will write any all you will put all the values here, Vx. So Vx here will be, you want to calculate Vx, let's say Vx, Ux will put here U cos theta. Acceleration that is 0, 1 to time t. So Vx is equal to U cos theta. So in horizontal direction, right, the velocity that would always, that would be constant. Or that would be U cos theta, always would be constant. In horizontal direction, the velocity is constant. Because you know that there is no acceleration. So here, the, what is the Vx? Vx, this at an instant, Vx, that would be U cos theta. In horizontal direction, this is the velocity, make the angle alpha. So this is Vx. So Vx, that would be U cos theta. Now, vertical direction, but on the y direction. So you will apply v equal to u plus at in y direction. So vy is equal to uy plus ay into t. Vy is equal to uy plus ay into t. So what will be the velocity v final you want to calculate? Vy. Uy is plus u sin theta. Ay is minus z, that is given here, into t. So you will write Vy is equal to u sin theta minus gt. Clear? Vy is equal to u sin theta minus gt. Want to calculate velocity at an instant, okay, along the y direction, in vertical direction, you can put the value of t here or you can get the answer. So this is the Vy and this is Vx. You can also write this velocity in vector form. In vector form, this is along the x-axis, this is y-axis. So you can write velocity vector if you want to write velocity vector, that is equal to, this is Vx along the x-axis, Vy along the y axis, so you can write Vx I cap plus Vy j cap. What will you write here? Velocity vector. Vx is u cos theta I cap, or Vy, that is u sin theta minus gt j cap. Here, this is in vector form. Here, velocity vector, that is u cos theta I cap plus u sin theta minus gt j cap. Now, have a look at this angle beta. If you want to calculate the value of alpha, value of alpha, how can you calculate the value of alpha here? Value of alpha. Simple, you can apply the tan alpha. Tan alpha. That is equal to Vy upon Vx. So you can write tan alpha equal to tan inverse. Vy upon Vx. So you can write alpha equal to tan inverse Vy. Vy is u sin theta minus gt. And Vx. Vx is u cos theta. Vx is u cos theta. This is the angle, alpha is the angle. So you can write here alpha. Alpha is the angle made by velocity with the horizontal. At an instant, so what we write here, velocity alpha. What is alpha? Alpha, this is the angle made by velocity, this is the velocity with the horizontal, this is horizontal, okay, at an instant, at time t. Instant comes at time t. Clear? This is the alpha. Alpha equal to tan inverse u sin theta minus gt upon u cos theta. This is the value of alpha. Okay. Now we are going to solve some questions related to the velocity. Clear? Now, first question. Speed of projectile is found to vary as 10 meter per second and u is greater than equal to 10 meter per second and less than equal to 20 meter per second when fired from ground to ground. What is the angle of projection? You want to calculate the angle of projection. So how can we calculate the angle of projection here? Angle of projection. Now, in this case, here minimum velocity with respect to time. Firstly, the y vertical component will decrease from here to here, from here till here, or vy at this point that would be zero. Then after vy, that will increase in downward direction. Okay, so you can say the speed will increase from here till here. Clear? Now here to here, the speed will decrease from here till here, and then after speed will increase from here till here. So let me know, yeah, here where is the velocity minimum? Where the point where the velocity is minimum? Velocity or speed that would be minimum at the highest point, or speed that would be maximum at the bottom most point. Here the speed is maximum ground to ground. So here at the projecting point, at the you can striking point, the speed that will be maximum, or at the maximum height, the speed that will be minimum. Clear? So simply in this case, the speed at the highest point, the highest point, the speed at the highest point, that is u cos theta. We have done this. This is cos theta. Speed at the highest point, that is cos theta. Clear? That is minimum velocity. Okay? Or that would be horizontal or ground to ground projection. So here you will write first of all maximum. Maximum velocity that is given 20. The maximum is given, the maximum speed that would be at the ground. So you know at the speed of projection, that is u, that is given 20 meter per second according to this question. This is the maximum speed at, that would be at the ground. Now minimum that would be at the highest point. So minimum speed will be at the highest point. Highest point. So what is the minimum speed at the highest point? That is, you know, u cos theta. U cos theta is 10 meter per second. Clear? So here this is u is 20, or u cos theta is 10. So you can put the value of u here. So u cos theta equal to 20, 10, or here u is 20, so you can put the value 20 cos theta, that is equal to 10. the cos theta that is equal to 1 by 2, tan by 20 that is 1 by 2, the theta that is equal to 60 degree. So this is the angle of projection. This is angle of projection. So which is the which answer is correct here? The C option, that is correct. Dear to everyone in the class. Now, next. Now, everyone in the class knows here and here. The speed here that is maximum, or at this point the speed is minimum. Matlab, what can you say here? At the projecting, at the projection point, the speed is maximum. So speed is maximum, so definitely kinetic energy also would be maximum. So kinetic energy, you know the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy will be maximum. So kinetic energy maximum, what will be the kinetic energy maximum? Simple. The half m u square. At the projecting point, the projection point, the speed is u. So kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy, that would be half m u square. Now, at the highest point, at the highest point, speed is minimum. So kinetic energy also would be minimum. Will be minimum. As you know, the speed at the highest point u cos theta, so you can write that this is the minimum speed. This is minimum. So kinetic energy minimum, you can write half L minimum square. So kinetic energy that is minimum, half m u cos theta square, half m u square cos square theta. This is the minimum kinetic energy. This is the maximum kinetic energy, half m u square. Okay, or minimum kinetic energy is half m v minimum square. So half m u cos theta square, half m u square cos square theta. Is it clear? The maximum kinetic energy at that would be the, at the striking point, you can carry over there the projection point, or minimum kinetic energy at the at would be at the highest point. Clear? Now related to this concept, okay, I am giving you one question here. Okay. Try to solve. Okay, this question is very simple. A boy weighing 50 kg finished long jumps by jumping a distance measured as 8 meter. Assuming that his angle of jump was 45 degree and he moved in parabolic path, his initial kinetic energy was. Uska initial kinetic energy kya hai? Okay, here you have to take g, value of g is 9.8. You have to take value of g. I am giving the 9.8 meter per second square. So you, here you want to calculate the initial kinetic energy. Now at the projection point, okay. From where you are projecting, you want to calculate the initial kinetic energy at that point. So how will you calculate here? First of all, what is given? The angle of projection, that is 45 degree, like theta is 45 degree. Or range is 8 meter. Or mass is 50 kg. Clear? So you will write here, first of all, range. So you will write R equal to, you know the formula, u square sine of 2 theta divided by g. So R, that is equal to 8 u square sine of 90 degree, 2 of 45, 2 into 45, that is 90. G, you can put 9.8. Sine of 90, that is 1. Sine of 90 degree, that is equal to 1. So u square, that is equal to 9.8 into 8. Clear? This, we can say this is the first equation. U square upon sine 90, that is, u square, that is equal to 9.8 into 8. Now, initial kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy. That you will write half m u square. This is also maximum kinetic energy. Half m u square, the half. What is the value of mass? That is 50. U square, you can write 9.8 into it from first equation. This would be here 4. You will write 200. Into 9.8, then what you get? Nine point into 200. So after solving this, you get 19602. So which option is correct? C option. That is correct here. Yes, it is clear to everyone in the class. So, this was the first slide of today lecture. Now here, now try to solve. This question is also easy for everyone in the class. A stone weighing 1 kg is thrown in space with unknown speed, unknown angle of projection. Speed is unknown or angle is unknown. U and theta, that are unknown. While descending in the later half part of the motion, This is the later half of part of the motion. It got stuck in a tree, but it was noted that the kinetic energy of the stone varied at kinetic greater than equal to 80 joule and less than equal to 100 joule for the part of the trajectory just before coming in contact with the tree. ओके okay, मतलब ऐसा नहीं लेना कि आपको ट्री के कॉन्टेक्ट में आ गया तो यू हैव टू टेकन द वेलोसिटी हियर इज यू जस्ट बिफोर तो जस्ट बिफोर इट हैज अ स्पीड ओके क्लियर नाउ टू फाइंड द मैक्सिमम हाइट एट रीच्ड बाय द स्टार यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द मैक्सिमम हाइट और दिस इज द मैक्सिमम हाइट एज यू नो तो हाउ विल यू कैलकुलेट तो हियर काइनेटिक एनर्जी गिवन दैट इज मिनिमम एंड मैक्सिमम Minimum kinetic energy that is 80 joule and maximum kinetic energy that is 100 joule. As you know, maximum kinetic energy that would be at the projection point, at this point, from where you are projecting the particle. Or minimum that would be at the highest point. Here, so which formula will you apply here? This is max k maximum half m u square or k minimum half m. U square cos square theta. Clear to everyone? So I am going to solve this by applying those formulas. Kmax. That is equal to 100 joule. Kmax is half m u square. That is 100. M is 1. M is given. That is 1. U square upon 2, that is 100. U square, that is equal to 200. Let's say this is the first equation. Now K minimum. K minimum half m U cos theta square. You can write half m U square cos square theta. That is equal to 80 joule. Here you can write half m is 1. U square is 200. Cos square theta. That is equal to 80. What will you write here? Cos square theta. That is equal to 80 by 100. Okay. You can also put the directly values here. Half mu square, that is here is 100. Okay, directly. Half mu square, that is 100. The 100 cos square theta, that is equal to 80. The cos square theta, 80 by 100. You know the half mu square. So you know the half mu square. This is the maximum kinetic energy. So you can also write kinetic energy at any instant k equal to maximum kinetic energy cos square theta. You can also write like this. So cos square theta, that is 80 by 100. Then cos theta, that is equal to root of, what will you write here? So you can write cos square. We will write the here cos square theta. Okay. The cos square theta here is 4 by 5. Clear? 4 by 5. Now, but you want to calculate the maximum height here. Maximum height reached by the star. So maximum height. What is the formula of maximum height? h u square sine square theta upon 2g, u square sine square theta upon 2g. So how can we calculate the value of sine square theta? So we need to calculate the value of sine theta here. We have to go in the 10th class, okay? So cos theta you can write here. You can apply the formula. You, as you know, sine square theta plus cos square theta, that is equal to 1. You know the identity here. Sine square theta plus cos square theta, that is equal to 1. Sine square theta, that is 1 minus cos square theta. One minus 4/5. This would be 1/5. Yeah. You will put all the values here. U square is 200. Sine square theta, that is 1/5. G is 10. You can put all the values here. So you can calculate here. 2 here get cancelled, 100. So 10/5. That is equal to 2 meter. 2 meter is the maximum height. 2 meter is the maximum height attained by this particle, okay, by this stone, okay. So which option is correct here? The B option, that is correct. So this question was very simple. Clear? So this expression you can write here, K max, K kinetic energy at an instant here. Half mv square is the K max cos square theta. Okay? Clear? You can also write like this. Now, next. So next question. So this question is related to the dot product, okay? You don't know about the dot product, okay? Not solve it. Now, next is, we are going to the next topic, that is trajectory equation. That is given in your NCERT book. Trajectory equation. Now, what is the trajectory equation? Do you know about the trajectory? First of all, trajectory. Is the path followed by particle. It is the path followed by the particle. जो path follow कर रहा है ना, उसको हम trajectory बोलते हैं. That is called trajectory. This is the path followed by the particle. Clear? It's called trajectory. It is the path followed by the particle. Clear? Now we want to get the equation, relation between y and x. That is the trajectory equation. Equation of curve. Okay. Is curve by equation kya hai? I'll give a point or not. Clear? So how will you calculate the trajectory equation here? Firstly, you will find, I take this is x-axis or this is y-axis or point of projection. I am going to take that is origin. This is 0, 0. Initial velocity is u, or this angle is theta. This is angle is theta. A particle at t equal to zero, that is here. T equal to zero pe particle yahan par hai. So at the time t, the particle that would be here, coordinate of this point that would be x comma y. Here, coordinate at an instant, let's say that is x comma y. And what is x? So this is 0 comma 0. So this is would be x, or this is that is y. So in physics language, what can we say here? X is the horizontal displacement. X minus 0. This is the x minus 0. That is a horizontal displacement in x direction, or you can say along the horizontal axis, horizontal direction. What is y? Y minus 0. That is the y. Y is the vertical displacement. You can say this is vertical displacement. You can say displacement along the y direction. And which equation you will apply here? So you firstly you will write all the here in x direction. In x direction and in y direction, first of all. What will you write in x direction? Ux, as you know, initial velocity u cos theta. Ex, that is 0. Now here, y, u sin theta, ay is minus z. Yeah. Now at an instant, displacement in x direction, that is plus x. At an instant, displacement in y direction, that is plus y. Yeah. Which equation will you apply here? At an instant, you will calculate the value of x and value of y. At an instant, the time is t. Initial velocity is given, acceleration is given, acceleration is constant. You want to calculate the displacement. Time is given. So which equation will you apply here? S equal to ut plus half at square. That is the second equation, kinematic second equation. You will write along the axis Sx is equal to ux into t plus half Ax into t square. Now here ux. Here Ax is 0. So simply you can write Ax is 0. This term, whole term, that would be 0. Value of Sx, that is plus x. Ux is u cos theta. Simple. For e time t, that is t. You can write x equal to u cos theta into t. This is the first equation. You can say, I call it, this is first equation. Now, y direction. Sy is equal to ui into t plus half ay into t square. You will put all the values here. Sy is plus y at an instant. Ui here is u sin theta. Okay, u sin theta into t plus half ay is minus z into t square. So y is equal to u sin theta into t minus half gt square. Is it clear? So this is the y. Y. At an instant, what is the value of y? So you can put the value of time here, or you can calculate the value of y. Y is given, you can calculate the time here. If y is given, this is second equation. So u sin theta into t minus half dt square, okay, at an instant, you can calculate the value of x, okay, at an instant, you can calculate the value of y. Now suppose you want to write the r vector, okay, position vector at an instant. If you want to write the position vector at an instant, position vector that would be like this. This would be the position vector. Yeah, this is the final point minus initial point. That is the position. This is r vector. R vector. So this is r vector. This one is r vector. What can we write the r vector? Simply, first of all, r vector. You can write the r vector simple. R vector position vector. X minus zero I cap. Y minus zero j cap. Plus y j cap. Clear? So r vector you can write. U cos theta into t u sin theta into t half gt square j cap. This is the position vector at an instant. U cos theta into t I cap u sin theta into t minus half gt square. Position vector at an instant, at time t. This is position vector. Position vector. Here. Now you want to calculate the trajectory equation here. So this is the x, you know the x at an instant and y at an instant. So how will you get the trajectory equation? By elimination of time, we will eliminate the time. There are two equations here. First of all, x equal to u cos theta into t. Another equation, that is y equal to u sin theta into t minus half gt square. Half gt square. U sin theta into t minus half gt square. So from the first equation, you can calculate the value of t from first equation. Here we want to eliminate the t. So t is equal to x upon u cos theta. You can write here y. Sin theta x upon u cos theta minus half t square. T is x upon u cos theta or square. What can we write here? Y equal to here u get cancelled. Yahan pe u cancel hone wala hai. Here g x square, here is u cos square theta. So here, so you can write y equal to sin theta upon cos theta, that is tan theta. So x tan theta minus this is x square, so g x square upon 2 u square cos square theta. So this is the equation y versus x. Y, okay, this is x. y relation between y and x. So this is the trajectory equation. You will say this equation is trajectory equation. ये जो equation है that is trajectory equation. This is called as trajectory equation. Trajectory equation. Yeah. Now suppose trajectory equation. So as you know in your 10th class beta, you have seen the quadratic equation. The maximum power of x in the quadratic equation, that is 2. So here this expression you can also write like this. I tell you y equal to, you can write like this, y equal to, this is you can write bx, or here you can write plus ax square. So we have A is minus g upon 2 u square cos square theta, matlab that means A is negative and B is tan theta. B is tan theta. So when you write here ax square plus bx equal to 0, so there would be two roots. When you write ax square plus suppose bx equal to 0, so as you know this is the quadratic equation, as you know this is x equal to 0, or you know this is x equal to minus b by a. When the class, so there will be two roots, but that means this is the quadratic equation. So here this is curve, y equal to curve equation, y equal to a dx plus a x square. So aapne kabhi se graph banaya hoga, that would be either would be like this, or that would be like this. That depends on the value of a. Here the value of a greater than 0 must be greater than 0, or this graph that would be a less than 0. Here our in this term, here a is negative, a is negative, so our graph that would be inverted, like that would be like this. मतलब हमारा ग्राफ जो होगा वो ऐसा होगा इस तरह से. This is called as, this is the maximum power of 2. So this is called as parabola. Parabola. Clear? Parabola. That means this is the equation of parabola. This is the equation of parabola. Y equal to x tan theta minus gx square upon 2u square cos square theta ax square plus bx. So the equation of parabola, or that is downward. Why it is downward? You will say downward. Okay, inverted, because here is coefficient of a x square, coefficient of x square, that is negative minus g upon this. So there that would be like this. So this is parabola, or that would be inverted. So in this case you can see, so this is the part of parabola. Suppose you make completely the parabola, that would be like this. Did you get your point or not? So here the y is 0, so x equal to 0 here, or another point, that is x is here. X that would be here minus b by a according to this. So x is 0 here, or this is x equal to minus b by a, minus b, where b is tan theta, or a is minus g upon 2u square cos square theta. You can put the value here. Then when you put x b minus b upon a, so you will get the range x equal to r. X equal to r. When you put all the here minus b by a, then you get x equal to r. As you know, this is x equal to r, this is the range x equal to r. So x equal to r or x equal to 0. So this is, there are the two roots. Here in this, clear? So in this, what you can say, the trajectory, this is the trajectory equation, maximum power of 2, or clear? So this is parabola. You will say this is parabola. Clear? So this related to this, related to this concept. Okay, we are going to solve one question here. Trajectory equation, first of trajectory, r followed by the particle, that is called trajectory. In x direction, ux u cos theta, ax is 0 at any instant, uy. X is u cos theta into t, y is u sin theta t minus half gt square. Here. Now, So I'm going to solve simple question, first question that is related to the trajectory question. A body is projected with velocity of 10 meter per second at angle of 45 degree with the horizontal. Find the equation of trajectory. आपको ट्रेजेक्ट्री का इक्वेशन चाहिए. हियर तो हियर इनिशियल वेलोसिटी दैट इज 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड एंड थीटा इज 45 डिग्री. थीटा इज 45 विद द हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ ट्रेजेक्ट्री. सिंपल यू विल राइट हियर ट्रेजेक्ट्री इक्वेशन. Trajectory equation. What is the trajectory equation here? Just okay. Is this way to arrange? Yes. Just wait. Okay. Yes. The body trajectory equation. So this is y equal to x tan theta minus gx square upon 2 u square cos square theta. You will write y equal to x tan theta minus gx square 2 u square cos square theta. So you put all the values here. It is right, simple. X 10 45 degree. 10 45 degree minus G. You can I am writing G, I am taking G is 10 here. X square 2 10 square. Cos square 45 degree. Minus. 10 cancel out हो जाएगा. Cos 45, 10 45 degrees 1. And cos 45 degree. That is 1 by root 2. X minus x square 20 1 by root 2 square. This would be 1 by 2. X minus x square 20 divided by 1 by 2. This would be 10. This is the trajectory equation. Equal to x square minus x square upon 10. This is the equation of trajectory. Now here, clear to everyone? This question, try to solve this question. This is given initial velocity that is 25 pi cap plus 20 j cap in vector form. In vector form, you know initial velocity in vector form. Initial velocity in vector form that is u cos theta i cap sin theta minus gt j cap. This is at the producing vector form, the initial velocity. U sin theta j cap. Initial velocity. At, you can put at t equal to 0 there. So here you can compare this one. Clear? You can compare. When you compare here, you can write here u cos theta is 25, u sin theta is 20. Velocity vector equal to u cos theta I cap at an instant. U cos theta I cap u sin theta minus gt j cap. You can write velocity is here 25 I cap plus u sin theta is 20, g is 10, or time is given, that is 2 seconds. Velocity vector that is equal to 25 pi cap plus 5 j cap. This is the first part. This is the first part. Velocity, okay, after 2 seconds. Now, displacement. Displacement is r vector. Initial vector is 0, r vector. As you know, u cos theta into t, u sin theta into t, minus half gt square j cap. So r vector equal to u cos theta into t, u cos theta is 25. 25. T, what is the t? T is 1. I kept u sin theta, that is 20 into 1. G is 10. T square, that is 1 square. J kept. R vector equal to 25 pi cap 25 plus 15 j cap. You can say this is the displacement vector. This is displacement. Final position minus initial position. So initial position, that is 0. You have taken the 0 origin here. You have taken the origin here. So r vector minus this vector, that is the displacement vector. Displacement vector, that is, you can see position u cos theta to t, I cap u sin theta t minus half gt square. After solving this, you get 25 I cap plus 15 j cap. Or velocity at t equal to 2 seconds, that is 25 I cap plus 5 j cap. Is it clear? Everyone in the class, okay. So this equation you can also write with another form. We will, okay, discuss in the next class. Okay, here you can see all the slides. Okay, before ending the slides, before ending the class here, all the slides I showed you. Okay. Velocity at an instant, okay, we have done. Velocity you can calculate at an instant. Speed, okay, we have solved some questions related to this. Maximum kinetic energy at the projection point and the striking point, minimum at the top point. Then after we have solved related to this kinetic energy, okay, two questions. that trajectory equations. Okay, we have derived here horizontal displacement as a function of x, vertical displacement as a function of time. So here you calculate the position vector, okay, as a function of time, or this horizontal displacement as a function of time. Now here this is the trajectory equation. You have to remember this. Okay, we solve one question related to this and this one. Okay, we will solve beta some more questions related to this in next class. Okay, thank you all of you. Bye. Take care.